Hello everyone, today I'm going to talk about the JavaScript oxidation compiler, Rolldown, and the future of Vite. In this talk, I'll introduce you the Oxc project, a little bit of Oxc's performance, introduction to the Rolldown bundler, and finally our roadmap. To start things off, my name is Boshen. For the last decade, my job has been a front-end configuration engineer. I configure things like Grunt, Gulp, and Webpack. I also worked at startups and large companies that have super large monorepos and web apps. As part of my interest in experimenting with new programming languages, I started working closely with JavaScript tools written in Rust. They are Rolldown, ISPEC, Biome, SWC, and NAPIS. In the meantime, I initiated the Oxc project and also became the member of the Rolldown project. Here's an overview of the Oxc project. We are ambitious to build a fully integrated JavaScript toolchain. There are binary applications, NPM packages, and Rust crates. It is a collection of JavaScript tools written in Rust. We have completed the parser, which is currently 3 times faster than SWC, and it passed all test 262 stage 4 tests, and the regular expressions, and also Babel and TypeScript. Most of the Babel and TypeScript tests. We have a linter, which is 50 to 100 times faster than ESLint and has more than 400 rules from popular ESLint plugins. We have a module resolution resolver, which is 28 times faster than Webpack's enhanced resolve. Currently, we are working on the transformer, which is going to be Babel compatible. And at present, TypeScript and ReactJSX transforms are complete, and we also implemented the latest TypeScript isolated decorations DTS emit. In the future, we are going to work on the formatter, which is going to be prettier compatible, and also a minifier that is going to be faster and better at compression size. Oxc also supports the upcoming rising stars projects such as Rolldown and the Nova JavaScript engine. So how did it all get started? It started as a learning project for Rust, writing a parser, and also performance engineering. I wrote a JavaScript and TypeScript parser from scratch, began more than 2 years ago. And once that was completed, I started writing a linter as an experiment, and I just kept going. Eventually, I released a tool called OXLint. It is designed to catch erroneous or useless code without requiring any configurations by default. It is 50 to 100 times faster than ESLint and scales with the number of CPU cores. There are over 400 rules with growing lists from a popular ESLint plugins. It supports ESLint ignore, ESLint comment space disabling, and partial ESLint RC JSON support. You can already try in your own project by calling npx oxlint. At my previous job, I had to work with super large code bases, and I often find the tools written in JavaScript to be struggling with such enormous amount of time. So I stress test oxlint in one of the largest monorepos in our company, which hosts all of TikTok's code for the web. It completed 120K files in 3.4 seconds. Once OXLint was released, Jason Miller from Shopify tried OXLint in one of their large monorepos, and here's what he said. OXLint has been a massive win for us at Shopify. Our previous linting setup took 75 minutes to run, so we were fanning it out across 40 pass workers in CI. By comparison, OXLint takes around 10 seconds to lint the same codebase on a single worker, and the output is easier to interpret. We even caught a few bugs that were hidden or skipped by our old setup when we migrated, and we probably have saved millions of dollars on infrastructure. In the meantime, Evan Yu showed interest after I tweeted a lot about Oxc and OXLint. He was amazed by OXLint performance when he ran in the Vue3 repo. And eventually, we got talking to each other, and one thing led to another, it was evident that a new bundler is needed to for Vite. So Rolldown was an experiment project by the author of NAPIS and a few friends. It got later picked up by Evan, and all the stakeholders got started talking to each other. It was eventually decided that Rolldown and Oxc is going to be the future of bundler for Vite. It aims to remove the DevPro consistent issue. It has a Rust core but allows JavaScript plugins. It aims to align with Rollup's API as much as possible, and it is going to have a lot of performance budget for new features. So why was Oxc picked for Rolldown? It boils down to three key factors: performance, correctness, and simplicity. For runtime performance, Oxc, the whole project, takes performance very seriously. We think of it as a budget for buying more features down the road and for our downstream tools. It uses continuous benchmarking methodology with code speed. And at the time, Rolldown was using SRC and then started experimenting with Oxc as well. Once switched, the parser and transformer made Rolldown faster and was 3 times faster than SWC, because there is a AST allocated in a memory allocator in Oxc. It consumes lower memory and is faster at dropping memory. And not just runtime, for compilation speed, we know that Rust is notorious about its compilation speed, and Oxc tries to minimize it. Rolldown's DX improved when they switched from SWC, so the save compile cycle increased by a lot. CI ran faster, and this is proved by Oxc CI, which runs under 3 minutes. For correctness and reliability, we have layers of test infrastructure. We have conformance suit on test262 Babel and TypeScript. We have lots of fuzzing, and there are people who fuzzes our projects and creates issues in our projects to this day. We have linter snapshot diagnostics for checking diagnostics, the correctness of our diagnostics. We have OXLint ecosystem CI, where we gather a lot of projects that use OXLint to check regressions. We have item potency testing, and we have a lot of code coverage. And we also have a end-to-end test where we use the top 3,000 NPM packages and test various things. And you can read more about our correctness and reliability approaches on our website. So now here's a quick Rolldown demo. In the previous setup, I said the end-to-end setup, there's a repo called Monitor OXC. There are 3,000 most popular NPM packages from NPM high impact. So download counts of 1 million or more per week, and dependent on by 500 or more other packages. And with Rolldown, it's a really simple config, and with just an input and a platform configuration. So when I imported all 3,000 packages statically into a single file, so that's a single file chunk with lots of code, it processed 46K files and generated 809 files with a 200 megabyte entry file. And the maximum memory usage was just only 7 megabytes. And the runtime completed in 3.26 seconds on my Mac M3. And to test chunking, I also imported 3,000 packages dynamically, and so it creates 3,000 chunks, processed 46K files, and generated almost 66K files together. And the memory consumption and runtime speed are the same. And here's a quick run in our setup. It only took like 3 seconds. Here's where we can watch it again. So all node run, Rolldown, and then 3,000 packages were completed in less than 3 seconds. So for the future, for the past and future roadmap, Rolldown's basic bundling is done, and code splitting is done. CJS, ESM, interrupt is finished, and basic bundling support are all complete. For milestone 2, tree shaking, CLI, source map, chunk hashing, advanced chunk splitting are all done, and rollup plugin compatibility are at 90%. There are only many edge cases that haven't been implemented yet. For Oxc, we finished TypeScript and JSX transform, and we are currently working on lowering to ES6, and a built-in modification should be done with a prototype by the end of the year. And by the end of the year, we also seek for deeper Vite integration, where running all starter templates are already finished, and Vite and will try Rolldown as a dependency and try to pass all ecosystem CIs. And possibly we are going to try and have a full bundle mode as well. To learn more, you can visit oxc.rs and rolldown.rs. We appreciate any kind of contribution. Thank you.